What's up, guys? Shane Starnes here, and I'm super excited to bring you guys the unboxing of the official retail version of the second generation Galaxy Fold from Samsung. As far as I know, this is one of 1,000 that are actually in the wild, so I'm pretty excited to be able to bring you guys this unboxing. And I'm really excited to see what changes have been made in the box, if there are any warnings that have been added as far as the durability and the care for the Galaxy Fold. We're gonna dive in right now. Let's go ahead and get started. So this is the 5G version of the Galaxy Fold. This does come standard with 512 GB of memory and 12 gigabytes of RAM. Of course, it comes with a Snapdragon 855 processor. We'll go ahead and open this box up, see what's inside. All right, and the sleeve comes off nice. Set the sleeve to the side there, slide out the inside box. And I didn't notice, but there's a little bit of Galaxy Fold branding on the second sleeve. This is the most premium unboxing that I've done in a while. It looks like I did it upside down. The Galaxy design is there on the front of that box as well. Go ahead and open this up and bam, there it is. This is the Galaxy Fold. And I love how they've got it unfolded already. It is much heavier than I thought it would be. Super thin, and that's a pretty massive 7.3 inch display. There are all kinds of warnings here, and I'm not sure exactly what they say considering I can't read this language. I can definitely tell that this is telling us not to peel up that what seemed to be a screen protector on the first generation. I remember Marques Brownlee and several others tried to peel up what seemed to be a screen protector and damage their devices. It's telling us don't do that. This looks like it's telling us that this is not water resistant. Don't get it wet. It looks like it's telling us not to store around credit or debit cards. There are magnets on the phone which help keep it closed, so you don't want to wipe your debit cards. And that looks like a key, so I'm not really sure. Maybe it's saying don't store it with keys. It's telling you here that there are magnets. And then I'm not sure what this is. Don't touch hard, maybe? Maybe that's saying don't touch hard. So anyways, we'll go ahead and remove the plastic. That's always my favorite part. All right, and this is the black Galaxy Fold. And that is super duper satisfying. And that hinge is super firm, like much firmer than I thought it would be whenever it's fully open. I don't feel like I can, there's not a lot of backwards flex. All right, so we'll look more at this here in just a moment. We'll set that to the side to see what else is in the box. Looks like a note from Samsung in a language that I cannot read. We've got some documentation here, Galaxy Fold Advantage Plus. I believe the Advantage Plus was the customer service experience that they were going to include with the Galaxy Fold. This is a $2,000 phone, so they said they wanted to go above and beyond with the customer service. I'm really interested to see what's in here. We'll set that to the side for now. We have the AKG sleeve and the Galaxy Buds, so these are also included. This is a black pair to go along with the black Galaxy Fold. That's $130 worth of Galaxy Buds that's just included there in the box, which is great considering it's a $2,000 phone. In this box here, looks like we have our charge cable. So this is a big USB-C to little USB-C cable. And then here we have some Galaxy Bud earbud replacements here, different sizes. All kind of parts for the Galaxy Buds. And then it looks like that's everything that was in that little box there. Set that to the side. We've got an adaptive fast charging brick. I was expecting the super fast charging brick. So I was a little surprised here. I was expecting the super fast charging brick. This is the charge brick that I got with my international Galaxy Note 10. That also came from Korea, but instead we got the adaptive fast charging brick, which I'm pretty sure that's the ancient tech. We'll compare some specs here real quick. On this one, we've got 9 volt at 1.67 amps or 5 volts at 2 amps. And on the super fast charging, We've got up to 11 volts at 2.25 amps. So this is definitely the older technology that came with the Galaxy Fold. I was really expecting the super fast charging brick to come along with this $2,000 phone. We've also got in here a big USB-C to little USB-C adapter, so you can quickly and easily transfer files from your older Galaxy phone to your new Galaxy phone with Smart Switch. So before we move along to the phone, I did want to take a look at what's inside this box here. All right, so we definitely get a case, which is nice. This is the carbon fiber case, the Kevlar case, excuse me. This is the Kevlar case that comes with the Galaxy Fold, and it does have a piece of glue here and here so that it sticks to the fold better. And we'll kind of set that to the side. You've got your SIM card tool there. We've got some various instructions here. This shows you how to apply the case. Okay, and I was really interested to see what this Galaxy Fold Advantage is all about, Advantage Plus. So there's a card there. This is Galaxy Fold 5G Advantage Plus. And it just tells you to go to samsung.com/SEC/Advantage Plus. And then there's a QR code there that you can scan, I guess, to register your phone for that Advantage Plus experience. If I pull up the website, obviously, you know, it's in Korean. I can't read anything here, so I'm not really sure what the benefit or the advantage of the Advantage Plus program is, but I'll just kind of scroll through so you can kind of see what's going on here. YouTube Premium, so it's gonna come with some YouTube Premium, probably for free, Hatch Premium. These may all be Korean exclusive, so maybe different when it gets to the US. Looks like maybe a free video game here as well, and possibly some free Galaxy themes. There's a Montblanc case here, so another case for the Galaxy Fold. This may be a percentage off. Somebody that reads Korean, let me know what this says. That's part of what the Advantage Plus program is there, and there will be a place here to scan your QR code to get registered. So we'll go ahead and power this up. The power button is here on the side. One thing that's missing from the Galaxy Fold is an in-display fingerprint sensor. The fingerprint sensor is over here on the side. But while this is booting up, I just wanted to give you guys a size comparison. So this is the Galaxy Fold folded versus the Galaxy Note 10. And you guys can see that it's quite a bit slimmer. It is quite a bit thicker. So it's like carrying around two Galaxy Note 10s. And if we take a look at next to the Galaxy Note 10 Plus, you can see that it is not much shorter, and as far as the thickness, not much wider there, and about twice as thick as the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. All right, it says open your phone to get started, so we'll go ahead and open this up. And that's that beautiful display. And just looking at the phone, the crease is not really obvious. When I tilt it into the light, it is absolutely obvious. So it sticks out like a sore thumb, and you can see the caps that have been placed here to protect the display from dust. They've added those caps there to keep dust out of that display. And then if you look real closely, it doesn't appear like there's a screen protector on the phone because that's been totally tucked in. So there's no chance of you thinking, oh, that's a screen protector, let me take it off, because it is now totally tucked in. So this is the little walkthrough that it gives you. It shows the phone folded, and then you unfold to go big. All right, so here's what our warning was telling us. We get a secondary warning here. It says, your Galaxy Fold includes a special protective layer on the main screen. Avoid pressing hard on the screen. Tap lightly to keep it safe. Your Galaxy Fold isn't water or dust resistant. Don't allow any liquids or foreign objects to enter it. Don't attach anything to the main screen, such as a screen protector. Wow, okay, so we're not allowed to use any type of screen protector on the Galaxy Fold that could damage it. Keep your Galaxy Fold away from credit cards, medical devices, and other objects that can be affected by magnets. All right, so now we have set up our Galaxy Fold. We can use the front screen. I'll be honest, the front screen leaves a lot to be desired. This is kind of like going back in time. I'm probably not going to do anything other than answer calls, maybe take pictures from this screen. I will probably always just choose to open up to the larger screen. So as far as the display is concerned, this is a 330-ish pixels per inch display. That's better than the brand new 7th gen iPad. Of course, the iPad's a little larger, but it only has about 250 pixels per inch. So you're gonna get a better resolution on this smaller display. As far as the brightness is concerned, this seems to get plenty bright. Colors look great as far as I can tell. Overall, for a foldable display, this looks really good. So here was an interesting quirk that I found. If I try to pull down from the right side of the screen, I'm not gonna get the notification panel, I'm gonna get the app drawer. You've actually gotta go way over here to get to the notification panel. I can see where that would bug me. There again, I may just get used to that without any issues. So I was gonna turn on the power sharing mode. We've got the wireless power share here. All right, so that's turned on, and we should be able to wirelessly charge our Galaxy Buds, which we're doing, which is pretty awesome. So this is able to wirelessly charge, it's able to power share. One of the huge features of the Galaxy Fold is the multi-active window. So I've got YouTube open up here. I'm able to watch a YouTube video. We'll just go ahead and open up this Warchant video. And I'm gonna turn the volume all the way down so it's not distracting. If we pull over from the left-hand side, there's a slew of other applications that you can open. I can open up a Chrome tab so I can simultaneously watch YouTube and check out the Bucks score. And then if I want to open up a third application, say I want to open up my Twitter app and scroll through Twitter, I have my Twitter app right down here at the bottom. You can actually move these around like so. The left-hand screen is going to be the bigger screen. If you have three open at all times, you'll have your two smaller screens over here. Be able to move this over here if we want to see it on that screen. Right, and then everybody wants to see what it looks like when you go from the little screen to the big screen. So we will open up our YouTube here and then take that over to the big screen. So that's how that works. There's actually about 100 or a little more than 100 applications that are designed to work perfectly with the Galaxy Fold. They're designed to fully fill the screen. Twitter, Facebook, Amazon Prime Video, YouTube have worked with Samsung to make sure that their applications are perfectly compatible with the Galaxy Fold. All right, so we are on Android version 9. And there's no telling when we'll have Android 10. So Android 10 is already available on the Pixel devices and even like the OnePlus 7 Pro, but we're gonna have Pi on the Galaxy Fold for a while. And being that this will not be the main device that's out there, there's gonna be a lot of S10s, a lot of Note 10s, not a lot of Folds. I have a feeling this will kind of go on the back burner. The Note devices are kind of already behind on updates from the Galaxy S series. And so I imagine we'll get the same thing with the Fold. All right, so yeah, there's definitely no micro SD card expansion here. It's a 512 gigabyte device. If we take a look at our storage, it is using 53 gigabytes, and I don't have a lot of apps or anything, no pictures, no videos, but just the system is taking up 53 gigabytes of storage. That's a ton of storage that's being taken just out of the box. We're left with about 486 gigabytes of available space. Yeah, that's staggering. 53 gigabytes for the system, but at least we have 512 to start with. So in case you're wondering, we do have an always-on display for the front display. And if we do the show always, we close it here, that's going to power up that always-on display. So one thing that was interesting, by default, the side button launches the camera. You also have the option here to open up Bixby, and then if you press and hold, by default, that will wake Bixby. You can also set that as your power button. Instead of that waking up Bixby, you can set that to your power off menu. So there's not really a power button here. There is a side button that controls the camera, Bixby, or opens any app that you choose. And you can press and hold to activate Bixby or the power off menu. Okay, another feature here is this link to Windows. Once you're linked, you'll get instant access to your photos, text, and more. This is in partnership with Microsoft. So that's another feature. You can just plug your phone up to your computer and get instant access to the data on your computer. So over the next week or so, I will be diving into the Galaxy Fold. So far, this is a stellar device. I can't wait to really dive into it and get to use it over the next couple of weeks. That about wraps it up for the unboxing video. Be sure that you're subscribed for much more coverage. I may have this phone, you know, a few weeks before anybody else, so I'll be sure to include tons of coverage on this channel. Make sure that you do click that notification bell so that you're notified every time I release a new video on the Galaxy Fold. Thanks guys for watching. Be blessed. I will see you in the next one.